Sellers. Number 9, James Green. Number 10, Ben Schultz. Number 12, Matthew Wigan. Number 17, Aiden Vaughn. Number 21, Josh Manessa. Number 22, Aiden Holt. Number 5, Matt Jones.
Good afternoon and welcome to Lillis Court here at Loras College for what should be yet another exciting men's volleyball game between the Loras College Duhawks and the Augustana Vikings. Joining me today, very special guest, is setter from the women's volleyball team, Sara Hoskins. Sara, how are you feeling today?
I'm excited. Came off of a tough loss last night against
Dominican,
and I think they're just ready to get back on the court and have some fun today.
Should be an exciting one for Loras today. Their senior day, recognizing three seniors. Number 3, Matt Jordan. Number 20, Patrick Mahoney. And number 22, David Beach. All three you will see here in the starting lineup, I believe. We should be in for a very exciting game. As Sara said, a tough, tough loss last night for the Duhawks, losing 3-2 against number 2, Dominican University. Duhawks led 2-0 and lost 3 straight, so definitely a hard one to swallow for not only the team, but definitely the fans in support here last night.
Definitely showed that they could play with those top-level teams. I know we had a great crowd come out, so it was a lot of fun, I think, for the crowd and for the players.
No doubt, for sure. These teams previously met, I believe Loras swept them last time.
Yeah, 3-0.
Down in Rock Island. So hopefully the Duhawks can repeat that again today. The senior Matt Jordan will be back to serve for the Duhawks to start this first set.
Good touch.
Oh, good point there from Augustana to start real quick. Look at the starting lineups for both teams. For Augustana, their six looks as number 4, Max Sellers. Number 9, Jacob Spicer. Number 10, Ben Schultz. Number 12, Matthew Deegan. Number 17, Aiden Bond. 21, Josh Van Essen. And number 32, Aiden Bolin. And as for the Duhawks, their six. Good point there from the Duhawks. They're starting six. Now Crowderville coming out. He was starting in there for them. 20, Patrick Mahoney. Number 22, David Beach. 24, Jake Filotto. 25, Corey Mayotte. And number 1, Cameron Manini. Four in the serve now. Patrick Mahoney with the kill. Good awareness there for Mahoney to get that kill from the start. Mayotte, oh my gosh.
Nice overpass kill.
Couple reception errors there from Augustana early in this first set.
You have number 29, Ryan Floyd, going back for the serve now.
Received that one a little better. Not as clean as I'm sure they'd
eye
like.
And out.
Duhawks up 4-1 early in this first set. Bench energy already high.
Ooh, quick middle play.
Good kill there from Schultz. It It'll be Bowen back to serve for the Vikings. And it goes right into the net. Point will go to Loris. And that'll send Mayotte back to serve.
Good aggressive topspin serve. Looks like they're going to send a free ball over. Hopefully they can utilize it.
Beach, Mayotte from back. Good piece from the Vikings.
Good hustle, though. Good hustle.
Very nice hustle. We saw a lot of hustle from this team last night in that loss to Dominican. Definitely needed the hustle against that team for sure.
Definitely a lot of grit, and you saw the competitiveness come out and literally everybody on the court, which was really fun to see.
No doubt. A lot of trash talking in that game last night.
A little tight.
Inked, bunt.
Good touch by Beach.
At the net.
Good block touch by David Beach up there.
It's a big wall to get over with Mahoney and Beach there. 6'3 and 6'4, kind of, you got to get a lot to get over those two.
Senior Pat, Trick Mahoney, going back to serve. Nice aggressive topspin serve.
That's unfortunate. Beach knew it too. Right off the arms, he knew it.
Those are always hard. You always second guess them.
No doubt. He would probably know. Hello, reception error.
Yeah, sometimes those float serves just come off your arms super weird. They do a lot of movement. That's why they're so useful when you play.
Van Essen at service for the Vikings. Floater receives that one better. Beast now with Filoto.
Off the block. Going to the middle for Mike. Good back row attack from Corey.
Very nice. That front for Augustana is looking good.
Ooh, good touch by Cameron Manini there in the back row. Covered a lot of grounds.
Just better offense there from Augustana. Mm-hmm. That front row doing a lot. Getting a lot of touches on those attacks from Loris. Beach, Filoto. Wow.
Yeah, it's really important to get those first ball kills after a serve. We talk about them a lot on our team. When the other team goes back to serve, you want to turn around quickly to get the ball back.
A lot of force behind Filoto's kill there.
Yes.
That man, he doesn't look like he's the biggest, but he can fly, that's for sure. He gets up there. Senior Beach back to serve. He did well back there serving for the Duhawks last night. Hopefully he can keep that going today. Good kill.
Good spot.
There. Very nice spot.
Lots of communication up there between the middle and the setter on where to set the ball, how high to set it.
Duhawks
to determine where they're going to swing.
Duhawks now take that lead back to two, leading 8-6.
Good touch
there from Beach.
Good hustle.
Good hustle from Mayotte. Just couldn't get there. Nice kill there from Bond.
Mm-hmm. Really hit it through the block there.
Bond back to serve. Filoto receives it. Beach. Filoto again. Oh!
Dang. That was really close.
It looked like caught the line from up here, but line judge obviously saw different. But, oh, my gosh.
Like we were talking about earlier, he gets up.
Yeah, he really does.
Yeah, and he thought it was in, too, going back to serve. Oh. That's hard.
Tough.
When those overpasses come over, you really just want to slam it back down. But.
Yep. No
doubt. Sometimes it just doesn't go your way. Now we can have Jake Filoto back to serve.
Yep.
Nice aggressive topspin.
On from the back row. Mike's there. Unfortunate attack error there from Bond.
Good receive. Augustana.
Bowen.
Whoa.
A little far.
Just a bit long. A little too much sauce on that one there from Bowen. Floto going on a little run here. Oh my goodness.
He returns the favor.
Yeah.
Good aggression though. Way to get the Duhawks a few points there in the serving run.
Keeping that 2-point lead up 11-9 over the Vikings.
You have Spicer back to serve for the Vikings. Good receive by Manini.
Beach, Mayotte.
Ooh, off the
block. My goodness. Oh.
Luckily, the up ref caught that.
I think Coach Ross is about to have a about to lose it if they didn't call that four hits there.
Yeah. Hey, play until the whistle's called.
Very true. Jordan back in, and we'll go back to serve for the Duhawks.
Sometimes you can be all lined up for a block and still comes down on your side.
Yeah, those ones are definitely hard to swallow for someone trying to go for a block.
Yeah.
You put so much effort in to get up there just for it to land right in front of you.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully he'll come back here with a nice high kill.
For sure. Deegan back to serve. Florida receives that one. Beach sets up Crotterville.
Just a hair.
That's unfortunate. Deegan serve up and clips in that.
Little free ball here, out of system. Good smart play by Cradiville.
Deegan, up for Bowen.
Touch off the block.
Oh man.
The hustle.
Unbelievable hustle there from Filotto. Energy's there on that Duhawk side. A lot of hustle. Definitely keeping it up, like I said, from last night for sure. Mahoney.
Good middle run. Looks like they're going to call it a net error for the Vikings. But again, good solid run out of Mahoney and Beach.
Yep. Floyd back in and back to serve for the Duhawks here. Serve over. Van Essen receives it. Schultz.
Mahoney with the block.
From Mahoney. Beach, Filotto, back row.
Good spot.
Ooh.
Looks like it was called out by the opposing line judge on our side. But it looks like it was in from the other line judge, so super close.
Very, very close spot there. Pull and serve, see for Mahoney. Beach, back to Mahoney.
Great
spot. Oh, yeah. Not a lot you can do there for the Vikings when you got the All-American Pat Mahoney rising up top.
And we saw a lot of that last night, him clipping that corner.
Yep.
Right where the libero just seemed to not be standing.
Mayotte serve just long and out of bounds.
You have Schultz coming back to serve here. Good hands by serve receive.
Ooh,
smart play.
Very nice.
Good. Sometimes not going up and trying to swing.
Hit as hard as you can. Sometimes works out very well.
Yes.
Good move there for Mayotte. Mahoney back to serve. Deegan Van Essen.
Great pass by the freshman.
Filoto.
Again. Smart plays are what seems to be getting the Duhawks most of their points today.
Oh, yeah. No need to be too aggressive right now.
Good serve. A little tight.
Oh!
Nice spot.
Very nice spot there from Mike. Augustana going to call first timeout here in this match. Duhawks going into his timeouts up 3, 17-14. So what are you liking so far from this Duhawks team early in this match?
They seem to be turning around the ball really fast, not letting the Vikings get too many points at the service line. And again, I think the middle setter connection is what's really helping the Duhawks here. We've seen Mahoney and now Michael go up a couple times, and just with some really smart swings that is placing them right where those Vikings are not, and I think that is what's really helping them today.
A couple service errors here early in this first set. We saw a lot of those service errors last night, and definitely a big reason of how Dominican managed to stay in that match last night. Mm-hmm. Definitely a good thing to see. Not a lot of those as much. Mm-hmm. Definitely want to limit those, especially today. Don't want to give up too many free points against this Augustana team that they have already previously beaten. Don't want to make it any more close than they'd really want to.
Again, a lot of aces last night, too.
They did. We had a lot of aces, but then just a couple of those errors that you just...
Yeah. Lining them up together, I think the stats were about almost equal.
Almost equal, but...
Again, they were just able to pull out a little bit last night.
Yep.
But here we are back with Mahoney to serve after the timeout. That was a great spot.
Ooh, that caught the line.
Yeah.
1-4, ace by Patrick Mahoney.
That's a good call by the up ref.
Yeah, very nice call.
Another ace. Oof.
Oh, my goodness.
Senior day festivities.
Oh, yeah. What a day for Mahoney. Couple aces, couple kills early. It's going to be a good senior day for him.
Mm-hmm. Going for number three there. Just hit the tape a little bit.
Ooh.
Not sure why the line judge is moving a little bit.
It's going to be points there for the Blue Hawks at the tip.
Another timeout.
Wow.
I think they've pulled ahead 5-6 points now, so trying to stop the momentum that the Duhawks have right now.
Coach Ducey not happy with his team's performance right now. I mean, Mahoney, like a couple aces, his serve's just killer.
Yeah.
That thing is just a nasty serve there for him.
Yeah, that's what's the hardest part. He topspin serves, which means that as soon as the ball goes over the net, it pretty much drops. And so having to get behind that as a passer is one of the more difficult serves to pass.
Coming off and with all the power and like the heat coming behind it too. Mm-hmm. It's not a slow one for sure. He gets a lot of power in that serve too. Duhawks up, like I said, up 6, 2014 in this first set. Duhawks already ready. They don't need that timeout. They're coming back onto the court early.
Yeah, vibes seem really good from the Duhawk bench and on the court.
No doubt.
Bench is definitely having some fun. They're known to kind of taunt the other team a little bit, but that's what makes the Duhawk bench the Duhawk bench.
Both teams back out. Buzzer sounds. And Mahoney will continue serving for the Duhawks.
Missed a little wide.
Wide right.
But again, still got a great amount of points for the Duhawks with those two aces.
Yep.
Essen back to serve for the Vikings.
Beach, Filoto.
Nice high hands.
Just go higher. Go higher, Filoto. I think his chest is about top of the net every time he gets up. Unreal bounce from Filoto.
With David Beach back to serve.
I think that's my favorite chant the bench does.
Yeah.
Let's get sexy.
Last night they had the whole crowd cheering it with them.
Awesome.
Great swing.
Wow.
These pumps.
Good awareness there off that reception there from the Vikings.
A couple of those we've seen this first set of just not taking off for much of the serve and it just going over the net a little bit. Duhok's definitely taking advantage of that. And a rotation error for the Vikings. Looks like they're setters in the wrong spot. Nice tough serve. Maybe a double. Oh. Yeah, there it is.
Double. Point. Kind of almost looked like Loris is going to get that point either way. Augustana looked as if no one knew who was going to go for that ball there.
Yeah. Yeah, it seems to be a little bit of some communication struggles on the Viking side. Nice aggressive serve. Almost didn't go over.
Pressing from Bolin to get there.
Good swing out of Michael.
Duhawks will take that first set of the. Very nice kill for Mike, 25-15. Set one victory. They'll take that 1-0 lead in this match. First set, sir, I'll ask you again, what are you liking after that first set?
Again, I think we're just really flowing really well as a team. Nothing seems to be going too badly, and everything seems to be going our way. We have good serve receive coming out of the back row, really solid sets coming from David Beach, and then, again, like I mentioned during the timeout, just the connections with the hitters seem to be what's really being the success for the Duhawks today.
And today, if you were here last night for that game against Dominican, you saw a couple guys that haven't touched the court yet, and Joe Horn and Dorian Fiorenza, two very important players for this team. Obviously, it doesn't look like they're he as well, but I mean, Fiorenza last night, 21 kills, season high. I believe, like you said earlier, I mean, unbelievable performance out of him last night. And Joe Horn, the assist leader for this team. Beach doing well. It looks like we almost don't necessarily need Horn.
Yeah.
I mean, it's, but those two for sure. Having those guys out there definitely gives this team an edge over some others with Dorian on that right side and even in the back row. Would love to see Dorian get out there more today, but
we'll see.
We'll see. I mean, they got everything going.
Yeah, the clan that's out there right now is doing a very nice job, so.
Very nice job. Filoto leading this team in kills right now with 4 after the first set. He's got it going early. Definitely good to see him going and rolling early in this match.
Hopefully this next set we kind of see a little more out of Cradiville. I think him on the right side is a very nice asset for the team. Swings hard down the line, so it would be nice to see that a little bit more this set.
Yep. Didn't see much of him last night. But definitely good to see him a lot today.
We'll see. Normally second set is when, you know, teams wake up a little bit. So I expect to see the Vikings come out a little stronger, a little more here, I guess.
At first set, it just looked as if their communication wasn't there. And they definitely don't have the energy that we see from the Duhawks right now. That bench is a little quiet. Definitely tell who wants this game more right now.
They look ready to go, though. They seem to have a different energy coming out onto the court. Some new players, new faces. Looks like a new middle. Rembert has come in for the Vikings. Maybe he can do a little bit something different for them today. Apply a little pressure. Looks like same starting six.
The Duhawks.
Of Cradiville, Manini, Mayotte, Filoto, Jaguar and Beach. We'll see if they can utilize this service even and get a first ball turnover. Miss serve will give the Duos the first point of the game.
Not the start Augustana probably wasn't looking for after that first set loss, to see that first serve go right into the net.
Looks like number 7, the Vikings, who just served as a freshman, so we'll see if he can come in and do some work.
Lodo.
Good pickup by Lobero for the Vikings. Oh, tip in the middle.
Good spot there from Bowen.
Looks like Duhawks thought it might have been up. Good hustle by both Cradivo and Manini, though, to try and get that ball. Then a smart play by the right side for the Vikings.
Patel will come in for Bowen and will go back to serve for the Vikings.
Ooh, great run. Don't see a pass to the middle very often as a set. Good pickup by Mikey. Great hustle by the Duhawks for that play. Again,
just
one
so
of those
long.
Tough tough breaks for the Vikings. Or for the Duhawks.
No doubt.
Good coverage, though.
Yeah, everyone. That left side with the Duhawks, they were flying around on their side.
I think they were everywhere but their position.
Sure looked like it.
Looks like the ball may have hit the antenna for the outside there, so it'll be a Duhawk point, and then Flato going back to serve.
Just right.
Pretty wide.
There's those service errors we were talking about earlier. A lot of those last night, and I think they've had quite a few of those throughout this season. Definitely probably one of their weaker points and giving up points.
I think it's a kind of a men's volleyball kind of thing. You sacrifice, you know, having those hard aggressive serves and aces at a discount for the missed serves.
No doubt.
So it'd be interesting to see what that turnover is.
Patel receives.
High swing for number 22. You have Jaguar going back to serve for the Duhawks. And that'll hit the antenna. Looks like a little miscommunication with the setter in the middle there for the Vikings. Ball was pushed a little too far.
Schultz near whiff on that one, too. Tall receives that serve. Whom sets up Morin.
Nice roll shot. Good ball from the back row. And again, another good pickup.
And Essen.
And they'll execute.
Very nice
kill. It's a kill for Essen for the Vikings, and he'll go back to serve.
He locks up 5-4.
It looks like we have Mahoney now in the front row, so him and Beach should be able to do some damage here.
No doubt. Yep, there it
is.
Yep,
there it is. And he'll do it right again.
Oh, right again.
Nice.
Oh.
Having a great day. Again, those overpasses seem to be what's shooting the Vikings in the foot right now.
Definitely a lot of those overpasses. We've seen, I think, about 5-6 already throughout this match, and we're only in the second set.
So have Degen coming in for the Vikings. And senior Matt Jordan back to serve. Nice aggressive
good
serve
there.
Good touch off the block from Corey and Mahoney.
Photo there. Beach up to Maya.
Great swing. Great push by Beach. And a block.
Good block.
From Beach and Mahoney to seal the deal.
That's a big wall you got to get by.
It was a great push by Beach for that last outside swing. He was all the way back at the 10-foot line on the opposite side of the court. Really impressive for a setter. Again. Oh, another aggressive serve, but it looks like it just missed.
Just missed.
Now we have Bolin coming in. And a missed serve from the Vikings. You have Mayotte back to serve.
Moreno there received that serve. Bolin.
Great pickup by Mayotte.
Beach Mayotte from the back.
Nice little off speed from Mayotte. Another
Marini's
pickup.
There.
Great ball from Beach.
That's in back row. Oh, man.
Lots of hustle on both sides of the court.
Oh.
Looks like it'll be called a lift.
That
could have gone both ways.
Yeah.
But that's just me.
Lifts are,
I think, the hardest thing to call.
I'm with you on that one. I look kind of.
I was thinking
clean,
maybe a double, but.
Yeah, no doubt.
Not a lift. You have Schultz back to serve for the Vikings, and
just
it'll
long.
Just miss. Again, like we just keep bringing up, the missed serves.
A lot of missed serves from both teams today already.
And you have Mahoney going back to serve. Again, having a really good senior day game.
Yeah, and
we talked about
Mahoney a lot. Last season, was the program's first All-American, along with their first team All-Conference bid, an ABCA All-Region bid, and an Academic All-Conference bid. Mm-hmm. So obviously, good reason why we say his name quite
a
bit.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he also had a perfect game, meaning that he hit 1,000. No errors out of all of his attempts is a very impressive feat for any volleyball player.
A very solid medal from Oaklawn, Illinois. Definitely going to be big loss for Duhawks next year and upcoming seasons, but hopefully those guys behind him will for sure be ready.
The missed serve brings Degen from Vikings back to serve. With a score 11-7, hopefully the Vikings may get some points here. Oh.
Ooh.
Tough luck at the net.
That's an unfortunate point to lose there for the Duhawks.
Sometimes the net is on your side and sometimes it isn't. Again with the tape. And a middle center connection.
Nice little solid attack there.
And you have Cradville coming into the game as David Beach goes back to serve. And Kelling back in for the Vikings to set.
So he receives that.
That's a really good set.
Essen. Oh,
great pass from Meany again. Going to Cradiville. And another overpass. Tries to get on the court, but Vikings pick it
Bolin.
Up.
Oh,
and a great swing out of number 32. That's Bolin.
My goodness. A lot of power behind that one there from Bolin.
Mm-hmm.
Patel coming back in to serve for the Vikings. Serve up. Receive from Manini.
Oh, nice try.
Good attempt
long.
There. Good attempt. Just too much sauce on that one.
Mm-hmm. Hopefully they'll try that connection again. It has been working for them this past set and a half. Good receive. Going to the outside for Cradiville. There he is.
There it is.
He loves that line shot.
Good to see him going.
Yeah. Nice, powerful hitter. I think the Loris team really has a good depth when it comes to their outsides and right sides. I bet Dylan has a hard time picking, you know, who's going to start all the time.
No doubt. I 100% agree with you on that.
A little bit of a
reception
off the hand, off the arms wrong for Patel for the Vikings.
Good
gives an ace
there.
To Filato. Another overpass. Looks like they'll
take advantage of it.
You see Matt Jordan on the sideline getting excited for his teammate.
The timeout Vikings. I mean, just a lot of overpasses for Augustine. I think that's a huge killer for them right now. And why they're down, obviously losing that first set and now down 15-10 going into that timeout. Definitely something you hope to see them fix.
Yeah, you definitely can see all the momentum is on the Duhawks side right now. The Vikings will have to dig deep to try and find, you know, that drive. And
Duhawks got everything going for them, for sure. Now, obviously, I mentioned you on the women's volleyball team. Unfortunate loss towards the end of the season for you guys. Probably wasn't the way you guys expected it to go. Other than that, how did you feel your guys' season went, and how are you excited for the upcoming years?
I think it went really well. I think we have a really strong group of women who are really passionate about the sport, and that really helped us come together as a team in some of those tougher games. And it makes me excited for, you know, next year to, again, put that to use and really get up there with those top teams like we see Coe and Warburg in our conference. So I'm excited to get back to work this summer. Their spring season starts this week, so it should be fun to see what they do with that. And then next season, putting it all together.
Yeah, only losing a couple seniors. Mm-hmm. Definitely still an experienced team, but also a young team as well.
Yeah.
Hopefully... We obviously wish you guys best of luck next year, and hopefully have as much success as you guys did this year.
Jake Filato back with the serve after the timeout. Nice aggressive one to start. Tip, good pickup. Oh, good hustle.
Oh, boy.
It's interesting. You don't really see your middles hit the ground that much, but Tivar has been on the ground quite a bit this second set.
And I think everyone so far that's been playing today for the Duhawks has at least touched the court once. A lot of hustle.
Yeah. I know that's something they worked on was some of those middle of the court shots, and then again, those block touches was something they did a lot in practice, so it's good to see it finally translating.
Tell Moreno.
Oh, good touch for the block. Good touch by Cradiville, just needed to turn his hands a little bit to get it in the court. You have Zavala back to serve.
He's up for Mayotte. Moreno.
Good touch again.
Good
may
touch
have been
there.
Out.
There's a 3-point Duhawks.
Yeah. Yep. Too bad the balls are just going to a little too far for that outside, and he's having to swing it straight into the antenna.
Keegan. Back to serve. Making his first appearance. He's joined me up here at the table. Keegan Godwin for his serve. And touch the court for the first time today. No headband for Keegan today.
Yeah, I was going to say, where's his headband?
Unfortunate serve there from Keegan.
Yeah, it's so hard coming from the bench to come in and serve on, you know, kind of a cold arm.
Yeah.
Trying to stay warm on the sidelines is one of the harder things.
Probably because he didn't have his headband today.
That's
his luck, the ninja headband.
SM back to serve for the Vikings. Looks like it'll go long.
That's long. 1-4. Jordan back in. And we'll go back to serve.
Duhawks up 17-13 towards the end of the second set. Hopefully Jordan can get him a few points here.
Patel receives that serve. Moreno.
Off the hands.
Three sets at Mahoney. Mahoney. Sellers was there. Schultz will tap.
Good pickup.
Oh, my goodness.
Lots of hustle.
Almost a little miscommunication from Beach and Lotto.
Same thing again, and Cameron is there to.
Good kill from Beach.
You always forget that the setter can go up and attack until they attack right in front of you.
You had a few of those this season.
Yeah.
A couple of those little sneaky kills from the setter there.
Yep. They're always fun. It's a good idea by Beach in that situation. Everyone on the Viking side was a little flustered.
Jordan served just long.
Looks like Dylan is frustrated with the call. Not really sure what it is, but.
We mentioned those kills from the setters. Duhawks gave up a lot of points from just those little, like,
yeah, dinks,
quick kills, yep, from the setters. And that loss versus Dominican.
Yeah, their setter was very aggressive.
Very aggressive.
I don't think we've seen yet this season. Hitting through the hands of the block was Bolin for the Vikings. That'll put number 22 back to serve.
Duoc still up to 18-16.
Oh, miss serve. Again, miss serves tallying up for both teams. I know on the women's side we can't really afford two or three, but
both teams at eight service errors. Definitely a number you would like to see go down, yeah, not only for Duoc's but for Augustana as well. And
yeah,
that's going to catch.
An ace for Mayotte.
Good spot there.
I know we saw during the Carthage game, we got ace on a couple times. So we're just not getting out of the way fast enough. That's how fast the balls are coming during that game. Oh, and that's lucky.
That was a huge break.
It looks like the outside, I think, can't cross over one of the back row players, and he's done it twice now. That's lucky break for Mayotte. He gets to serve again.
Augustana obviously not happy with that call there.
Yeah.
But definitely a huge break.
Yeah. There. It's one of those things that really shouldn't be an issue, if anything, but
yep.
Sometimes you just forget.
Yep. Essen back row. Kill.
Good shot by Essen.
Good
right
back
in that
row
deep
attack.
Corner.
Schultz now back to serve for the Vikings. Beach Filoto?
Oh, hit the antenna, sadly.
Just antenna.
Pretty good swing, though. The Vikings are trying to catch up a little bit here. Brought the score to 18-20.
Vikings bench trying to get this team back into it. Oh,
another
man.
Dump by Beach.
Ooh.
Smart play.
Very smart. Very smart.
And Beach isn't one who normally just kind of throws it down. He kind of just lets it air over the net right short in the court where nobody's standing or can get to fast enough.
Mahoney to serve for the Duhawks. Ooh. Oh, that's unfortunate. I think Mike just tripped over Jordan there. Good hustle there from the Duhawks. Yeah, she's got get it over there. Bolin?
Again, number 32 for the Vikings, having a good day. Good pass from Manini for the serve receive. Going outside to Filato, and he'll execute
he'll
off the block.
Way to keep that two point difference.
Yeah, I think that's one of the things that the Duhawks did really well yesterday in the first two sets against number two. Saying that 2 points ahead and then being able to keep the 2 points ahead was something that really helped them win those first two sets last night.
We served receive from Bolin. Going up to Essen. Essen finds his spot.
And here we see the Vikings kind of pulling ahead a little bit. Not pulling ahead, but just kind of closing that gap.
Essen now at six kills on the afternoon. And Patel will go back to serve for the Vikings.
Tough luck.
Reception error there for Colorado, and now the Vikings have tied it up at 22.
Looks like the Duhas just need to find a little bit of momentum here. As we talked about the timeout, it was on the Duhawks' side, but it looks like it's just shifting just a little bit over to the Vikings' side. Duhawks just need a good pass and good setup to execute on a swing. Again, Patel back to serve. He's going on a nice little run here for the Vikings.
Very nice run. A much-needed run for the Vikings, no doubt. Lotto each shoulder.
There it is. You don't expect it out of Mikey either. He has a really heavy arm swing.
Yep. Definitely much needed point there. Stop that little run, Patel. Just put the Vikings on.
Yeah, you hear the Viking bench a little bit for the first time this game.
They're trying to get into it. Right now, Lotto. Each.
Interesting. That's unfortunate. See, Debar's not really happy getting blocked there, but he'll find the drive to push it through again. Just
and
out.
Rembert serve just a little too long. Mike back to serve. Patel receives it. Schultz set up.
Good execution from Vikings.
Schultz is pumped.
Yeah, lots of talk at the net last night and today, I'm guessing.
I'm sure. They seem to always have a little...
Always something to say.
Chit-chat going on at the net.
You have SM back to serve for the Vikings.
Do you guys have that much talking up at the net?
We do not. Literally none.
That's the serve long.
I wish we could, honestly.
Let's just be men's volleyball thing now, apparently.
Score's a little tight now, 25-24 in Duhawks' favor. Push 1 point here, and they have the second set. Oh. Vikings did a great job of coming back, though, with Patel serving.
Just long.
All tied up here at 25. Again, have to win by two to take the match.
The early and middle stage of this set, you didn't think we'd come down to this point in the second set, no doubt.
Yeah, Moringo back to serve. Good
serve.
There it is. Duhawk bench getting a little into that. Again, push 1 point, and Duhawks have the second set with Mayotte back to serve.
Marino receives that. Bolin set up.
Off the hands.
Man.
Bolin's having a really nice game.
Very good game.
Just a freshman, too, so he seems to be providing a lot of support for the Vikings. They're a pretty young team.
Very young team.
Very young, actually.
Not
only junior is number 21, Essen. Good pass. There it is.
Good kill from Mahoney.
Mahoney's kill celebrations are always fun to watch.
Yep. You talked about Sam being young. Only one senior on the team.
Yeah.
But for sure, definitely.
Really young. It'll be interesting to see how they fare these next few years.
Definitely. Probably see a lot more success from them.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Attack from Bolin.
See if they can finish it here.
Beach Filoto.
Yep.
There you go. That got the crowd going.
Yeah, nice job.
Good
effort for the Duhawks, pushing through that, a little bit of adversity.
Duhawks take 28-26. Second set victory, put them up 2-0. We'll talk about Augustana first. Sarah, if you're Coach Ducey, what are you telling your team right now, down 2-0 and after a very hard-fought second set? What are you telling your team?
I think the biggest thing for them is kind of just the energy and the momentum that they want to have on the court. You saw it at the end. You know, they were getting hyped. Crowd's getting hyped for them. I think if they try and keep that going into this third set, they'll find a lot more success. And, again, those overpasses seem to be what's killing them. It's a really simple thing, but it causes really big energy shifts in the game on the Duhawk side when they can get a ball straight down to the grounds. So I think limiting those serve-receive errors and then, again, finding that energy and that drive is what's really going to help them.
Yeah. On that Duhawk side, your Ross, what do you think Ross is over on his team in that Duhawk huddle right now?
Finish. Obviously, I don't think he's going to be very happy with how close the last game was, and starting out strong is something that we do really well for the Duhawks, and I think maintaining that throughout the whole game is going to be their goal for this game. I think everything is going pretty well, actually, on all sides. But again, just finishing, keeping it in three. We saw it last night. They started up 2-0 and then lost in five. This will be a really good moment for them to get it and just get it done in three.
Definitely a much-needed win after that. Like I said, we keep mentioning a very tough loss for sure. But it'll for sure be, if they can put this way in three, that would be a huge bounce back game for sure.
Yeah, yep. Yeah, not the usual starters for the Duhawks, but even then, they still seem to be playing with the same gusto and the same teamworkness, I guess would be the right word.
You mentioned it. This team definitely has a lot of depth on it. There's no weak spot on this Duhawk team, seems to be, even with guys like Fiorenza and Horn not playing. Those guys up behind them are ready to come in, and it shows for sure.
It shows how competitive their practices are then, too. You know, you have that Fiorenza and then Prattville, Filato at practices. Like, that's not only giving your defense a really good looks at balls, but it's also making it really competitive to fight for that starting spot.
No doubt. It definitely, and the team just likes to have fun, too. Continuously, even down against Dominican last night, definitely a spot they didn't want to be. That team still, their bench always getting loud for the guys on the court. I think that's just a huge thing to have for this team.
Yeah.
Hopefully Augustana can get some energy going for them.
Yeah, it looks like they're having a nice long talk over there.
Yeah, they're really utilizing this intermission between sets here.
And again, they're a young team, so I think Ducey's providing a lot of assistance and a lot of, you know, mentorship to them on how to handle, you know, this college games are a lot different than high school games.
Yep.
So these guys are getting really great experience to where I'm excited to see where they end up in the next few years when these guys are now juniors and seniors.
Yeah. I mean, entering today's game, Augustana is 6-12, 2-5 in conference play. I wouldn't be surprised if those two records flip in the following years to come. And then Duhawks at 16-4 and 5-2 coming into today. Wouldn't be surprised if that stays about the same.
Tough conference, CCIW. You have Carthage and North Central that are top dogs in national tournaments that they get to play against in their conference, which is impressive.
Pretty sure both of them are top five right now.
Yeah.
You know, North Central's sitting at five. I think Carthage three.
Three, yep. Off the hands. Good hustle, though, by the libero number four.
Point. Jordan.
Nice senior day ace for Jordan.
Good ace there.
It's always fun on senior day when the seniors get a point, get to go extra crazy.
Oh, yeah.
Nice aggressive serve again. Went back to 32. Blocked by Corey. Bench is on the court pretty much.
Bench is excited after that one.
I think the first time that they've stopped 32 in the front row, actually.
Yeah. I think almost every time we've seen Bolin go up, he's gotten either a point or...
Miss is just out for Jordan. Oh, yeah, Patel coming in to serve. And Michael coming back in. It's been middle for the Duhawks.
Along with Manini.
Oh, I guess Manini's... Meanies in for the middle. So you have Cradiville and Mahoney in the front row right now, along with Mayotte on the outside. We'll see who they go to. Goes to the middle to Mahoney.
Right.
Ooh, lucky, oh, wow. Lucky pass over the net.
For real.
Little out of system there.
Sellers sets up Essen.
Good pickup by Manini. And a smart play by Mayotte.
Very
with the
smart.
Net. Patel Tell. With the free ball over.
Each. Patel. They're going to set up Moreno. Oh.
Good pickup. Putting it away, maybe. Nope, not yet.
Oh, man. Oh, Augustana will come out at that point.
Big momentum swing there.
Huge.
You don't really see a lot of long sets in men's volleyball, so it's always quite the entertainment when it goes past, you know, two times over the net.
Oh, yeah.
Patel will stay serving for the Vikings. Good effort, though, for both sides.
No doubt. A lot of hustle out of each player. Beach will go to Cradiville.
Just misses long.
Just long.
Looks like he's looking for that back corner. Oh, he was in the net. Okay,
in
so it is
net.
Our point.
There were a lot of in-the-net calls last night, too.
Yeah. A lot of in-the-net and then a lot of over the line at the net,
yep.
Which is really important when it comes to the safety of the players.
Yeah. Essen.
That's a great shot by Essen. That corner found us a lot of success last night.
Very true. Essen playing well for the Vikings here. That's his seventh kill of the afternoon. Rembert serving for the Vikings. Beach sets up Mayotte.
Ooh, oh. Very smart. Almost looked like it wasn't going to go over.
Yeah, I thought he was about to put it right into the net. Good awareness, though, from Mayotte to find that hole and just drop it in.
And he'll go back to serve. There, another overpass. This time they pick it up, though.
Peach.
They're kind of, Vikings seem to be picking up on what the Duhawks seem to be doing.
Ooh.
Oh, in the net.
In the net.
Again, just sometimes get a little too aggressive.
Yep.
Some noise from the Vikings bench on that one. We're all tied up here at four.
Oh.
He goes for it again. Second time's a charm.
Again. Good awareness from Beach. Just to find the open spot right in the middle, all six Vikings. Mahoney back to serve for the Duhawks.
Fault, yeah.
Yep.
Always hard when you have such a long approach to try and judge how far you're going to step.
Yeah.
Number 22 back to serve for the Vikings.
Moreno.
Looks like you have Filato back on the outside. A little tight.
Oh. Beach into the net.
That's an interesting call. Beach is back row, I'm pretty sure, so. It's interesting that they didn't get a call for the Vikings of them being over the net.
Beach sets up for Lodo. Bolin.
Really strong.
Oh,
great pickup.
Wow.
Great pickup. Great pickup again.
Oh, my gosh.
Everywhere.
Are you kidding?
Number 32 back to swing. Great pickup.
Oh, my gosh.
Bench is going crazy.
Oh.
Oh, it's out.
Out of bounds.
Oh,
my
gosh. That is a very
lucky that is
call.
A brutal break for the Vikings. Oh, my goodness.
Some may say a home court advantage for that one.
Yeah. Oh, man.
David Beach back to serve. Quite the effort for both sides of the court. Little missed pass from the Vikings. Free ball sending over.
Beach.
Good run out of the middle. Ooh, their setter tries to dump. Isn't successful, however.
Oh, Sellers there. Essen's going to set up Bolin. His is going to be just wide right.
You can kind of see how much of a momentum shift that those big plays call. You saw the bench and the court for Loris go absolutely crazy after that point, and then Vikings kind of struggle to pick up from that.
Deegan's going to set up Schultz.
Good swing.
Ooh.
Looks like it just nabbed that back corner.
Just caught that line.
It's a good run for number 10, Schultz.
Schultz will now go back to serve.
Cradwell entered the game, I think, a little bit ago, so we'll see if he can get some swings here. Looks like he will.
There he is.
Ooh. Great swing.
Good touch on that. I stay in the front. Over.
Interesting.
He needs to set up Bolin.
Good push touch. On the block.
Bolin again.
Looks like he took some off because of the block.
Cradaville.
There it is.
That's oh, my gosh. Goodness gracious.
Yeah, he loves that line.
Wow.
Yeah, that was impressive.
He's pumped. Bench is pumped. Fans are pumped.
I don't think the fans know what just happened, honestly.
No, it happened so fast.
Oh, unlucky.
Good ace from Filato.
Yeah, it's good to see Cradaville enter the game a little bit with that swing. Yep. Can't really leave any bit of open net for him.
Nope. Remember, he's met the line.
Okay. The men's team gets a little, I would say, aggressive.
Yep.
Lots of adrenaline.
Yeah.
Probably caffeine, too.
Yeah, a little bit.
Snips the antenna there for Colato.
Unfortunate error there, too.
Degen going back to serve for the Vikings. Scores at 10-8, Duhawks.
Oh.
Tough serve. Right
good
in between Manini and Matt.
Good ace there from Degen.
Again, we'll kind of see the momentum shift again.
Yep. ARC's Beach going to set up Cradaville.
There he is.
Beat pump.
He's very happy with that swing.
Yeah, he is.
He doesn't go for the corners very often. He just kind of just goes straight down, which is even more a bit impressive.
Jordan back in, and we'll go back to serve.
Good deep serve.
Set up for Essen.
Good pickup, too.
Good touch. Maya. Reno's there.
Going to the outside again. Oh, finds the court there. That's a really good spot.
Good spot from Essen.
Good court awareness by him. To see that the ball is set maybe a little bit too far out and him to cut it that way.
Essen and Bolin really keeping the Vikings in this match right now. Mm-hmm.
Tells back to serve for the Vikings.
I think without those two, the result right now would be a little different.
Mm-hmm. Again, this is just
long. That's Augustana's 11th service error.
Yeah, and you look at those service errors and you kind of look at the scores. If you just took those away, how close the game would be. or how much it could differ.
Oh, reception here from Patel. And an ace from Floyd. See if Floyd can go on a little run here. Sets up Moreno.
Good touch off the block. A little tight.
Ooh. Ooh.
That just stinks.
Yeah, that's a bummer.
Sometimes it gets caught in the light.
Yep.
And you think
think
it's on their side and it comes down right in front of you.
I believe that.
Ooh, tough luck for Patel.
Patel didn't know how he wanted to pass that.
Timeout from the Vikings to kind of stop the momentum that the Duhawks have right now.
Smart timeout there from Augustana. Like you said, don't want to get that momentum too one-sided.
Yeah, good serving from the service line.
Duhawks going into the timeout, 15-10. Looking to close this one out in three. And definitely, again, senior day, very nice senior day for Pat Mahoney and Matt Jordan as well, even Beach. Beach, obviously, with most of the assists, if not all of them, for Loris right now. Mm-hmm. And then Jordan coming in, getting lots of good serves for the Duhawks. But now getting that offense started in defense. And then Mahoney, obviously, the All-American, doing his thing. We're not too surprised from what he's given us today.
Yeah, definitely just continuing to push points for the Duhawks. First one to 20 is kind of what we do on the women's side. Take it 5 points at a time. Say Vikings are kind of going over game plan right now. They seem a little flustered.
Yep.
Maybe adjusting the serve receive a little bit to give Patel a little bit of a break. Looks like the Vikings come out with a little bit more gusto, so
yep.
They seem ready to go. Oh, and a missed serve. That's sometimes the goal of a timeout, is to just get a missed serve.
Yep.
Looks like the coach succeeded there.
Lambert to serve for the Vikings. Mayotte receives it. Beach sets up Mayotte.
Smart shot.
Oh, good spot there for Mayotte.
They don't look like they're going very fast, but just the placement of the ball makes it almost impossible to get to.
No doubt.
And he'll go back to serve.
And
he'll serve it out.
And just a bit long.
Brings our total to a staggering 14 missed serves, which is higher than normal, surprisingly.
Mm.
And missed serve after missed serve.
Yeah.
Some would say a game of missed serves.
26 total service errors between both teams. Mahoney serves. That one stays in.
Yeah, Patel passed that one really nicely. Way to get up for Beach.
Schultz.
It's a really good connection. And a really good swing by Schultz. Looks like 32 is coming back into the game. I'd be willing to guess most of the balls will go to him now.
Yep.
Again, Mikey on the ground. Looks like it's kind of switched a little bit.
Yep.
We see
momentum switching.
Yeah, we saw a lot of overpasses from the Vikings the first two sets, and now Duhawks seem to be struggling a little bit, keeping it on our side. Just gives a testament to how fast the serves are coming.
And then you serve that serve. Beach can sit up Mayotte.
There's
a kill from Mayotte.
Fortunately, off the block for the Vikings, it's really hard to get to.
Mm-hmm.
And you have senior David Beach back to serve. Scores 18-14, Duhawks. Ooh, good touch.
Wow.
Look at all those pancakes.
Filato.
We haven't seen him in a while.
I have not seen much of him lately. That's a very, very nice kill there.
Very scrappy effort by the Vikings, though.
Yeah. Hey,
just a little
just squeaks over.
Yeah. Good spot for the middle.
Senna Moreno. Heaney. Beach.
There's Bradville. Tyler. Looks like they're on the net for the block.
On the net.
Beach still at the service line.
Loris with 11 aces this afternoon. That's a very impressive number.
It is.
Essen from the back.
Nice pickup. Out of system ball here for the Duhawks.
Meany.
Good idea by Cradwell.
Good. Yep.
Looks like number 10 will go back to serve Schultz. We have Credeville on the outside. Good set.
Marina's just got to get it over. Nini, Beach, Credeville.
And there he is. He's successful again.
Smart play there from Credeville.
I think that's what he tried to do the last set he got, but this time he was successful.
Lotto back.
This is just wide out. Just again. We have Degen back to serve for the Vikings. Nice aggressive float serve.
Beach.
Looks like there may have been somebody under the net, but looks like they're not going to get the call.
Vikings down 4, 21-17.
And a little tight again.
Oh.
Very impressive.
Very impressive.
Looks like Ducey is not very happy. Looks like Beach is back row, so they're trying to try and get a setter kill call, which you can't do in the back row. We'll be, let's see, interesting. So pretty much when David Beach is in the back row, the setter, he cannot go up and touch a ball that's over the net or put a ball over the net while jumping. And it looks like what Ducey was calling was him doing that. It looks like the down ref thinks that that happened, but then the up ref will agree. Just one of those unfortunate calls.
Just an unfortunate.
It looked really nice.
Did look nice. It looked very good. Deegan still back to serve.
See ya. And there it is. We always like to say it. Whoever wins the point after, a questionable call, that's who the point truly belonged to.
Yep.
We say the ball doesn't lie.
Ball
so.
Don't lie. Ball don't lie.
But again, Jordan. Another service error.
yeah, another service error. 28 in total.
You got Jordan back to serve for the Duhawks, hoping to close out the set.
Oh, good block.
Glad to see he's a little excited. Oh, he's had a few issues with the block. Oh, very excited.
Duhawks going into the timeout, 23-18. Obviously looking to close out this match. Just a couple more points. Definitely a very, very solid game from the Duhawks. I mean, other than their service errors, being at 15, definitely a lot going for them, for sure. And unfortunately for Augustana, just never looked like they could get anything going. They seem to find stuff late in the sets when and have like really have to fight back to get into this set. But again, I guess that's what you get with having like a young team.
I think the drive and the effort is all there.
Yep.
It's just putting it all together at the right moments is what's really affecting the Vikings right now.
And obviously, being down in most in all three of these sets, definitely hard to keep that energy, but definitely not a lot of energy or excitement from that bench, really. Compared to, like, Loris, not a lot of energy from that
side. Can't knock Loris at all. They're playing a really clean game of volleyball today.
Very good game of volleyball.
But I'd say in terms of bench wars, I'd say ours is definitely one.
It's definitely one of those things where, for Loris, you want to get this win.
Yes.
Not just for the team, but also for those three seniors in the program.
Exactly. Jordan back to serve.
Setting
back
up
to 32.
Bowling.
And he'll be successful.
Mm. Good spot there from Bowling.
Looks like he's almost jumping over the block.
Seriously.
And then it looks like Patel will go back to serve. He went on a run last time, so it'll be interesting to see how he does now. Handled very nicely.
Beach.
And there's Cradiville again.
Oh my goodness.
Very fast arm swing.
Ben's loved that one.
Tyler's still holding it. Cradiville's still holding his hand down.
Match point for your Lord, Alistair.
Match point. The
Duhawks. Lots of chirping from the bench.
Floyd's serving. Tyler receives it. They're going to set up Essen.
Good block.
Good touch.
Kept alive.
Floyd. Beach. Mahony.
Oh, nice try. Just wide.
Just out.
He really wanted that one, too.
What a way to end it. Have your senior finish the game
I'm
off?
Honestly wouldn't be surprised if they went back to him for the serve
no
receive.
No doubt. No doubt.
But you have Mayotte on the outside and Filato in the back row, so lots of options.
Oh,
and it'll end on a miss serve.
End on a miss serve.
We probably could have
guessed
that.
Of course, miss serves. The killer for both teams today. Loris will take that set 25-20 and take the 3-0 sweep over the Augustana Vikings. Sarah, what do you think? What are your thoughts about today's game?
I think it went really well for the Duhawks. I think coming off of a tough loss last night, this was a really good opportunity for them to, gain that confidence back and still play well, and I think they did just that. I think they did a good job of not letting Augustana come back too much and still maintaining what their level of play should be was really important for them today.
And as for Augustana, that drops them to 6-13 and 2-6 in conference play. And for the Duhawks, they move to 17-4 and 6-2 for conference. Augustana will go back home and play number 5 North Central on Wednesday. That'll be a very tough game for the Vikings. And as for the Duhawks, they are back here tomorrow against North Park, where it should be another exciting game. Thank you for tuning in. Great game from the Duhawks, 3-0 sweep. Sarah, thanks for joining me today.
Thanks
Hopefully we have
me.
You at the table another time.
Yep.
And we'll catch you around.